My name is Lorne Molleken. I'm the head coach and general manager of the Saskatoon Blades. Coaching is demanding. You know, you're dealing with 20 plus players every day. They all have different personalities and, you know, different things make them tick. It is a long day here at the rink. You know, on many days we do work out as coaches. You know, and when we're on the ice, there's lots of teaching involved. You know, there is some resistance drills that we will get involved in. As the day wears on, obviously fatigue plays a factor, and you know, you want to be as sharp as possible so that when you're communicating to the players, they understand fully what you're trying to say.
This year, the Saskatoon Food Bank asked me to participate in the Food Basket Challenge. I have to survive 1 week eating only the food items someone using the food bank has to live on.
So today we started off the Food Basket Challenge, and over 20 participants from Saskatoon came to pick up their food basket. So the baskets are a typical amount of food that anyone who comes to the food bank would pick up. The participants will try to live off the basket for up to 1 week, and they are allowed 5 pantry items and to go to soup kitchens, and also $5 to spend during the week.
They give you enough food to last for 2 or 3 days. We need to make it last for 7 days. The normal person that uses a food bank, they have to make it last for 14 days.
Within the challenge, you're allowed to spend $5 on. So what I've decided to do is probably get, you know, some of these soups and probably a dozen eggs. You know, I've never really been on a budget before in all of my life. $4.98, so I'm not gonna get any closer to $5 than that. The biggest thing is the amount of food that we received in our hamper. There isn't a whole bunch, and some of the corn wasn't very good, and there was some mold on it.
You can tell you've never done this.
The other thing with the strawberries, some of them were not up to eating standard.
Probably a third is edible.
With the fresh vegetables that they and fruits that they gave us, probably going to have to eat them here in the next couple of days. Basically have 14 days to live off of this. I mean, I don't know how they do it. My stomach was upset and I didn't feel very good after breakfast yesterday. But that afternoon, we had to climb on the team bus for our final exhibition game in Regina against the Pats.
Hurry, Coxie! Hurry, Josh! Pucks and people to the net. Jesse, you got the box! Benny! Walking up the wall, you gotta get it deep, eh? You got nothing.
Benny! Your man!
After the game, we headed over to Boston Pizza for our post-game meal, where everyone had spaghetti and meatballs. And once everyone was done eating, it was back on the bus, and I made a spinach salad. That was my post-game meal. Check it out. Pretty good. Pretty good. So when you're hungry, it tastes good. Trust me. Nothing's really changed as far as breakfast. The yogurt's starting to get a little bit low. The strawberries are getting low. At lunchtime, a bowl of soup and a toasted hot dog bun. I didn't feel very, very good at all. And, you know, this afternoon, the energy level kind of hit rock bottom. We've got no width on our attack. We've got all three guys on
right on one side of the ice. So let's make sure we're spreading out the ice through the neutral zone. Make sure we're in good positions to receive pucks. Let's have a good start. Let's get the job done here. Let's go to work, boys. Good job.
After the game now, it's starting to hit me a little bit, so my stomach's starting to churn a little bit. And when I get home, probably a couple boiled eggs, hard-boiled eggs is what we're gonna tackle tonight.
You know what? Today's probably been the most difficult day, I think. Not a whole bunch of energy and just kind of feeling down. After the game, I thought I was hungry, but really had no appetite when I got home. And basically the same for the start of day number four. A few strawberries and a cup of coffee. And at lunchtime, I had four soda crackers.
On Sunday, my daughter, Tana, invited me over for the family's dinner.
It looks pretty good.
It's delicious.
The roast beef looks...
The roast beef is good.
Tana took several of the items left in my hamper and got creative with them.
Okay, Dad. Kind of surprise. So it's potato, corn on the cob, three eggs, spinach, and some turkey slices.
That was probably the best meal that I've had to this point. Not having a great variety of food and being able to eat what you want to eat has been real, real difficult. I've said this a number of times, you make do with what you have.
On day five, a couple of Food Basket Challenge participants and I decided to go to the Friendship Inn for lunch.
It was my first time in the Friendship Inn. You know, you look around and the first thing that I noticed was the kids that were in there. And the place was packed. The lineup was just about out the door. Wow. We had some vegetables. I think it was a little bit of squash, some beans, some roasted potatoes with gravy. And a hot hamburger sandwich. And probably to top it off was, we got a cookie. Well, usually I'm a big eater, but throughout this challenge, my appetite is disappearing. And
it was a busy morning around here. I had a meeting with one of our scouts. I did several media interviews, had meetings with the coaching staff, and had a sit-down with one of our star players.
Well, you know, I think with each day that goes by, you feel different. I think I had a couple crackers about 10:30. Went home this morning.
Okay.
Had a cup of coffee, come to the rink, and now I'm going to have whatever strawberries I have left. I'd offer you guys a strawberry, but... Well, for lunch was a packet of Compliments noodle soup. Once I was done that, though, I kind of had an empty feeling in my stomach today wanting more, and that's the first time in a long time that's happened. My stomach is starting to growl. I'm hungry now. What I'm used to is having a choice of different foods and going home for a big dinner each and every night, or when we're on the road with the hockey team, having a good meal after the game and, you know, having a big lunch, or those items or those situations over this last week didn't happen. I mean, it was one of the most difficult things that I've ever had to do, and if I had to live on what I received from the food bank and doing the job that I'm doing now, there's not a chance that I'd survive. Not a chance.